Good afternoon, American Academy parents. I hope you all had a great week. It was very short due to a snow day. I wanted to take a few moments to personally go over the slides about our math program that I presented at two meetings last week that many parents attended. Thank you if you did. And many parents weren't able to attend. So I'm going to spend just a few minutes going over those slides and that information with all of our parents. So why are we looking at our math program here at American Academy? What problem are we even trying to solve? Well, there are several factors to consider. Math growth and achievement have not been as high as we would like at American Academy. Now, there are many reasons for that, and we are studying each one of them in detail because we want to make sure that our kids are growing and achieving at the highest levels possible. In addition, the program that we use, Saxon Math, has not been kept up to date over the years. Saxon Math was sold years ago, and since then it has changed publishers multiple times. Versions have not been keeping up to date with Colorado academic standards, and as more academic standards are changed and added, that has become more of a challenge for us at American Academy, as well as getting our hands on updated materials without the Saxon program being a really active program. In addition, as those standards have changed, we've had to increasingly add supplemental resources and supplemental instruction for our kids to make sure they're getting every single standard. That's really challenging to do consistently across all three campuses. And finally, because we're working on our achievement and growth in math, we know that this year we need new materials for math and updated professional development across the board. So we would be getting new materials and updated professional development regardless of if we stayed with Saxon Math or if we moved to another math program. I want to emphasize that our goal in this endeavor, as always, is to maximize math growth and achievement for all of our kids so that they are ready to excel in advanced mathematics in high school, college, and most importantly, their lives. So I want to give you a little background on Saxon Math. Why did we pick Saxon Math? I was one of the founders of American Academy back in 2004. What we did to pick a math program is we literally looked at the top elementary and middle schools in the state of Colorado. And one thing those amazing high-performing schools had in common was Saxon Math. That was a big driver for us picking Saxon Math. Interestingly, if you were to do that same analysis today, you will find that not many of them still are using Saxon Math. We also picked Saxon for its scientifically proven approach of repetition and spiraling. And it builds a really strong foundation for our kids. And our kids have done fantastic on Saxon Math. They really have. I know my own children have absolutely excelled in high school and beyond in mathematics thanks to that strong foundation. So we're every bit as dedicated to the idea of a very strong foundation for our kids in mathematics. Today though, because we don't have, we're not getting updates to the Saxon program, they did update to a 2018 version. When we requested samples, every single textbook was exactly the same. Literally, page 297 looked just like page 297 in the 2008 version. The only change was the covers. The covers now say Common Core Math and have a different picture. Other than that, it's exactly the same program with the same, following the same set of standards as they were a decade ago. So that's been our biggest challenge with Saxon. It also hasn't proved to be terribly adaptable for all our learners, right? We have a wide range of learners, from very high achieving kids to kids that are really struggling with math, and we want to make sure that we're serving all of them really, really well. So what have we done so far? Our principals have spent the beginning of this year going through, first they started with Saxon. So they went through the Saxon math program. They got their teams involved, so they did off-sites with each grade level. This is across all three campuses. And they did a crosswalk, standard by standard, between the state standards and Saxon Math to kind of see where we are and where our holes are. There are lots and lots of standards for each grade level, so this was a full-day off-site exercise for each grade level in order to do this analysis. It was an incredible analysis, and they spent a lot of time doing it. They found lots and lots of gaps and lots of places where we just simply don't align. The 2018 Unified Improvement Plan for American Academy focuses on math achievement and growth. That's where we really need to make sure that we are shoring ourselves up as a school. So again, as part of that focus, we decided to examine our existing math program and see if we could find a way to make it match with state standards, either by getting the latest version or doing whatever we needed to do. Given that there isn't really an updated latest version, we came to the conclusion that we're going to have to start looking outside of Saxon math to see if we can find a math program that meets our needs, that meets American Academy's philosophy, and will help our students grow and achieve and excel in high school, college, and beyond. So that analysis is underway. On the parent survey, thank you so much to our parents who took the survey. 688 of you took it. On that survey, we got a lot of feedback. The majority of our parents are generally satisfied with our current math programs and the challenges that our math program provides, as well as the supports that our math program provide. About 20 to 25% of you have concerns on homework in one direction or another. Some think it's too much, some think it's too little. Homework, of course, is very much dependent on your child. I want to address some other common themes as we analyzed the comments from the parent survey. A lot of families chose American Academy because of our Saxon math program. We understand that. Us too. So we understand that and respect that. And we are going to respect the philosophy that was behind Saxon math as we look for something that is still being kept current. Families are concerned that we will move to the same math program that many of you came from in your previous schools that you didn't feel like was working for your children. So I do want to reassure you that we are not moving. Parents specifically called out everyday math. We are not looking at everyday math. Generally, we are not looking at math programs that our parents potentially, that our kids would have come from. I really want to reassure parents that we are not looking at math programs that is going to present mathematics in some crazy way that parents don't understand. We are very much looking to follow American Academy's philosophy and the philosophy that we've had for 10 years around math. It'll make sense to parents, in other words. We are seeking a good balance between traditional concrete math and some conceptual reasoning and real-world problem solving. That's the balance that we are trying to make sure that we seek. And families expressed they would like more resources available to them at home. We would too. So that is absolutely a priority as we're looking to move forward. So where do we go from here? We are continuing to evaluate all programs. If we find that there isn't something that is going to be better than what we already have, we may stay with what we already have. So we are looking at all programs and comparing them to state standards and to what we know our parents want from a math program and American Academy's general philosophy around math. We are going to talk to top performing schools that have made the choice to move away from Saxon. What did they go to? Why did they decide to move away from Saxon? We will also talk to the top performing schools that are still using Saxon. There's a couple. And so we'll talk to them about that. And we have spoken to some schools already. Our goal is to narrow the field down to two options in the next couple of weeks. And when we've got two options, we plan to do a vendor showcase so that parents can come in and look at the two options and provide us some feedback. We would give you some kind of rubric for those who are interested. This is not a popularity vote, but it is absolutely something where we want to get as much feedback as possible so that we can make an informed decision. We will visit schools that have implemented both of the programs that we've narrowed it down to, talk to them about the good stuff, talk to them about the holes in the program. We do know there is no silver bullet. There is no program that is going to magically make everything perfect. We just need to make sure we understand the positives and negatives of every single program as we're looking to consider them. Our goal is to select a program by early March and make an investment in that program across our three campuses for next year. Our PTOs have agreed to work with us, so we will be able to, thanks to 5A, the passage of 5A, we will be able to support buying sort of the minimum that we need across three campuses. And our PTOs have agreed to have this be their focus for their spring events rather than bleachers or something else, so that they can help us get kind of from the basics to the Cadillac. So we're super grateful to all of our parents for always supporting our school's needs, no matter what they are, from year to year. And we will be working on a comprehensive professional development plan for our teachers that will start this spring. It isn't enough to just give them a couple of days before the beginning of school. So we will start that comprehensive professional development this spring, do it again at the beginning of school, and then continue throughout the school year next year to support our teachers. We will have a very thought through transition plan for moving from our current program to our new program, assuming we decide to move away from Saxon. And we will make sure to communicate to that to parents as we go. I think I've covered everything. I really appreciate you taking the time to listen. You're welcome to email me with any questions you might have. Have a fantastic weekend.